They say it was against God's will that Saviador was settled by humans. Some claim that we would have had an easier time settling the universe had we done it in peaceful coexistence with our creators. Personally, I think we would never have gotten to where we are today without the species wars. The species wars were the fuel for our creativity. They brought us prestige and progress and led to the creation of a new human race. The split from our creators led us to new worlds, to new ingenuity, and to new wars. The wars made us what we are today. The spirit of Saviador is our constant companion. It is the beacon that guides us from colony to colony. It illuminates the darkness. We revere it. We honor it. We would die for it. We didn't encounter any other intelligent life forms on our forays into space, which gave rise to the belief that the universe was made for humans, and that all we had to do was stretch out our hands and reap the bounty of its treasures. Finding Triamon was like finding the lost paradise again. Conditions on the surface of the planet were absolutely perfect. Almost too perfect, some felt. But Triamon was not the first planet we've settled. It's the 14th. So we went about its settlement with a set routine. The only thing standing in our way, as it usually happens, was us. Times have changed since the Species War. We are no longer the only human species in the universe. We continue to develop in different directions. The challenges of the universe have allowed us to escape the shackles of evolution. There are no more limits to our creativity. There is only one decision left for us to make: biogenesis or cybernetics. Each human species has developed its own methods and strategies for war since the uprisings on Saviador, and they're nearly perfected. But every war needs to end sometime. It just wears itself out and gets lost to history. What follows is a cosmic moment of creative emptiness known as freedom. Even now we're starting to create great things, signing pacts, and creating a memorial to peace, so that its emptiness might not seem quite so pointless. But just because you can't see a silent enemy doesn't mean he doesn't exist. The invisible is ever present and always nearby. So remember this. No war is ever over. Each end is also the beginning of something new.
This was Stellarvox News. Today marks the end of a long and arduous journey for over 12,000 colonists. The migrants have been traveling for nearly 8 years from the Nara colony to the recently developed Ionos system. The colony ships Cherries, Dion, Medea, and Oravia are expected to arrive at the Spire soon. Most of the people on board the four colony ships will soon start their new lives on a world almost too beautiful to be real. Almost too perfect to clear woods for settlements and cities. Almost too close to paradise to be cultivated and planted with monocultures, Triamon. These people have been traveling for 3.5 light years, 33 trillion kilometers of uncertainty, and they are now just 1.6 billion kilometers from their new home. An 80-minute job if they could travel in ice speed.
This is the commander of the Dion. Please excuse the interruption. I'm afraid all communications are down while our route takes us past Clade. The Brown Dwarf is the 7th and largest heavenly body in the Ionos system. If you are on one of the observation decks or looking out one of the panoramic windows, you can admire its glorious ring system with a diameter of over 3 million kilometers.
What the...
Okay, fire at will. Your targeting indicator will signal when an enemy is in range.
Requesting assistance.
Shields down! Need to... My engines are hit!
side vaporized. Even angels are mortal.
Thank you.
after me.
Champions unit terminated.
That's how we'll get him. Side eliminated.
Shields have taken a hit.
This is Noah from the escort. Impressive work, Gunner. Not bad for a rookie. We have a spare Oberon down in the docking bay. As you may have noticed, my wingman position just opened up. I need someone in the cockpit. Right. Welcome to the squadron. Your position is 3 starboard. Hurry up and get down to Hangar 2. I'll see you outside.
This is Stellar Vox News. As reported recently, a serious incident has taken place near Glaive. The attack destroyed the colony ship Medea and caused the death of more than 3,000 colonists. While passing near the Glaive satellite Lye Wing, the convoy of ships came under fire from squadrons of Jad Baron fighters. The attack was obviously thoroughly planned out. The ships were only attacked after they had entered the high radiation field around the star of Glaive, which prevents interstellar radio communication. Rumors have been rife for weeks that the Jad Baron might have a base in Glaive's atmosphere, or on one of its larger moons. There is much speculation on the effect this incident will have on the upcoming Council, and how the two opposing powers will react. Both the Tai and the Genites have stationed several large warships within sight of the spire. The council itself will be attended by a Tai delegation led by Ambassador Mirivoy, a Genite delegation led by Senator Amos Litherin, and a Sapiens delegation led by Admiral-designate Jaron Jira. This is the first time in over 80 years that a Sapiens has held such high office. Although some, particularly the Tai, claim that Jira is just a Genite puppet. A mission from the Uranir Church of the Keeper is also expected to arrive sometime today. It will be led by Todor Sisto Zyrebaton, who says he wants to discuss a revelation of truly monstrous proportions. The tragedy of the Medea is bound to create tension between the factions before the historic meeting has even started. This is Lavina 5 for Stellar Vox Veritas.
Hold your position at the Dione until we are docked to the spire. We can take a break after that.
Securing the battleship is our highest priority!
This is the Spire Orbital Station. Welcome to our idyllic new colony, Trimon. Enjoy the sunrises and the breathtaking views of the planet while we orbit it at a height of 2,000 kilometers. Admire the Nimbus, the shimmering rim of ice asteroids that makes this world unique. Head to our relaxation and recreation zones to enjoy gravity, a life under an open sky, and clean, clear air. Spire leaves nothing to be desired.
Do you see the Genite carrier docking on the spire? That's the Sebulon, one of the most modern ships of its generation. Compared to it, our colony ships look like they're from the Stone Age. Over on 1 to Spire Station. I'm picking up a scrambled signal from the Sebulon. That's strange. An ultra-modern technological juggernaut, but the comm system is fracked.
Thank you. explosion on the Sebulon!
I see fighter squadrons leaving the Sebulon. Solo stunts will not be tolerated. Return to your position. Damn it! They're opening fire! Noah to Oberon Wing. Return fire.
This is the Sebulon.
You've got one on your tail. Try to dodge his fire.
The
Sebulon's on a collision course with the Spire. It's going to collide with the station. Get out of here! Be around now! Get out of there before the shockwave gets you! Try to get your ship under control. You're headed straight for the Nimbus.
Checking systems, cockpit check. The cockpit is undamaged. Engine check. The engines are undamaged. Starting the engines. Navigation system check. Navigation system online. Calculating ship's position. Position, Nimbus, sector 373/2. Checking weapons systems. Cannot retrieve information. Two unknown objects detected. Starting manual. Test. Destroy the two unknown objects to complete the weapon calibration and test. Systems online. System check complete. Calculating route to Spire. Calculations complete. The Oberon service system wishes you a good flight.
Oberon 5, are you okay? Squadron leader to Oberon 5. Come in. The Sebulon exploded. Two of its squadrons are attacking us, and those maniacs are flying like they're hopped up on amphetamines. 5. I've got you on the screen again. Now get your butt over here as quick as you can. It's all going to hell in a handbasket. Got him on the run.
This is Noah. Congratulations, Oberon 5. That was some brilliant flying back from the Nimbus.
direct Commander Noah at the Spire to receive further missions.
See ya.
Contact Commander Noah at the Spire to receive further missions. jobs are completed in open sectors. You can access these sectors at any time. Even without a job, you will most likely encounter other pilots in these sectors. You can complete the jobs whenever you like, and you can also accept several jobs at once. Most jobs are related to an open area with several sectors. If the job does not mention a specific sector, you can complete the objectives in all the sectors of an area like the Nimbus. Receive the sensor probe's coordinates. Once you get within 150 meters of probe, you can interact with it to scan the sector.
identified as new target.
Go into squadron formation.
No matches with the training fighter's signature have been found. You can continue the search in the outer Nimbus or return to the Spire and continue the mission at a later time. Partial goals that have already been completed do not have to be replayed if you leave a sector.